You see, I'm a big advocate for the people of African descent all over the world to come back to Africa to invest their resources, their expertise, their knowledge and experiences in different sectors of the African economy. But to be honest, if we do not get leadership right, no matter their investments, our growth will be slow and insignificant. And time is a luxury we cannot afford. So the fastest way for us to grow is to fix leadership. And leadership cannot be fixed if we as individuals do not fix our minds. Let me explain.
This man you see was a two-term governor of a state in Nigeria. He was sentenced to 12 years in prison for diverting over 8 billion naira of the state funds into a private account. Barely 6 months after his conviction, he managed to get out of jail. Now, that sounds bad, but what is worse is this. When he got out of jail, he was welcomed like a hero. This man pleaded guilty for stealing over $250 million when he was the state governor. He was sentenced to 13 years in prison and he served only 4 years. When he returned, he was also welcomed like a hero. This man right here is the current serving governor of a state. He was caught on camera taking $5 million bribe from a contractor. Even with this evidence, the people still supported him and made him a two-term governor.
Now you can see that it's impossible to get quality leadership if we don't build a society of quality individuals. The king is nothing without the kingmaker. And in this case, we are the kingmakers. We the people give them the power they possess. Until we build our minds to look beyond religious and tribal sentiments, we will continue to have leaders who will steal public funds and open the gates to foreigners to take our resources while we continue to struggle. Our biggest problem is ignorance, so that is why you have to share this video, because the more enlightened Africans are, the better our chances of building a better Africa.